Hey everyone, my name is Fluxtrance, and I'm collaborating with Paradox Interactive to bring you a tutorial on how to create a realistic beachfront in city skylines. Whether you're creating a map set in the tropics or building a city near the beach, a nice coastal feature can really bring your build to the next level. I'll cover a variety of techniques used to create beaches in different settings, so feel free to mix and match and try to create something unique for your own build. Before we begin, keep in mind that a full collection of all the mods and assets I'll be using will be available in the video description. You can also find them in my global build map collection on the Steam Workshop. None of these are really mandatory, but you'll find you can achieve a better result with a few key mods and a nice selection of custom assets. To start, we'll define the basic shape of our coast with the level tool. This is by far the most powerful terraforming tool, and if you can master this with the smoothing tool, not only will it save you a ton of time, but it'll also give you a lot more control over what you're doing. With the level tool selected, hover over part of the terrain a few notches below the waterline and right-click. This is how you select the height of your level tool. Now you can set the strength slider to 1 and create the sand just beneath the water level. Do this again with the height just above water level to create the beach itself. Make sure that you have a great enough height distance between these two surfaces because when we go to smooth this out, if that slope where the water meets the sand isn't steep enough, the water will start riding up onto the beach and kind of floating around in little blotches. Use the level tool again to create tiers in the ocean floor that move away from the beach. You'll also want to create a sharp line right at the grass line to define the edge of your beach. Adding jagged edges with the level tool like I'm doing here is actually a really nice technique that's applicable in a lot of places when you want to add little cliffs or noise to your terrain. Now here is where the level tool really shines. Using a smaller brush size, match the height of various ocean depths and brush quickly side to side to create noise in your ocean floor. We'll then switch to the smooth tool to blend this noise into our terrain. You can also right-click with the smooth tool for a stronger smoothing effect. I like to imagine my smooth tool is like the current of the ocean, so I'm allowing little banks of sand to extend out in some areas while I'm also aggressively smoothing out others. Try multiple passes of creating noise and then smoothing it out to get a more realistic look. You can use a similar technique when creating cliffs near natural beachfronts. Make sharp, aggressive elements that reach out towards the coast, then smooth the crevices for a more realistic look. You can also try using the shift tool here. This is the tool that lets you raise and lower terrain, and gently pull from the cliff faces and crevices to add surface detail. For our simple beachfront, use this tool to create protective foredunes. Next, we're going to want to add some pathways to the beach. For our simple beachfront, we'll stick with the straight paths every 2 to 3 houses. This is something you often find in beachfronts with lower populations. For our dense beachfront, I'm mimicking more of a public beach access area with curvy paths that connect and meet at breaks in the foredunes. For the simple beachfront, I'm also going to use the prop line tool mod with the fence mode enabled to draw some fences. If you're using fence props like I am, you'll also need the find it mod to access these props. Now, let's move on to the detailing. For this, I like to work in passes, so we'll start with the largest and most defining features like rocks and trees, and then we'll work our way down towards the smaller features like bushes and grass. Creating clusters of these larger objects rather than just filling the space is the real key. On later passes, you can expand on these clusters with shorter foliage and bushes. My absolute favorite tip for this foliage pass technique is object clustering with Move It. So firstly, you obviously need the Move It mod. You'll also need the Prop and Tree Anarchy mod, which you want to enable with Shift plus P. That'll disable your Prop and Tree collision. And then you can get on to actually applying this tip. So first, create a cluster of foliage, then select the Marquee tool with Move It, highlight your cluster, and then press Ctrl plus C to copy your selection. Now you can just move around, rotate the selection, and plop down your foliage prefab. This will save you a ton of time. Now be careful with this because it is really easy to quickly fill a space with tons of objects and will in turn drop your frame rate. Less really is more when creating these clusters. You can always add additional passes, and using sparse clusters means you can layer them to hide repetition. I like to save my game after every single pass in case I go too far and I want to roll back. Finally, let's add some beach props. For the simple beachfront, I decided I wanted some fences to keep the visitors off the foredunes. I also decided that the simple and dense beachfront should probably have some lifeguard towers. The last step is to scatter some towels, chairs, surfboards, and other common beach items along the beach. If you're filling a large space, the Move It cluster trick works fantastic for this as well. And that's it. I hope these tips gave you some ideas on how to design beachfronts in your own projects. And if you liked the video, be sure to subscribe for more tutorials like this one.